ان شاء الله نبتدي سيشن 4. ان شاء الله يكون معنا الفيرست سبيكر استاذ دكتور طارق الدياسطي, بريزيدنت اوف راديولوجيكال سوسايتي اند بروفيسور اوف يورولوجي اند راديولوجي سنتر منصور يونيفرسيتي.
بتوع الكارتك لسه بيسلموا على بعض اهي. ثانك يو مستر تشيرمان. السلام عليكم. انا سعيد ان انا ابتدي السيشن بالفيرست كيس فور انترستينج كيس سيشن. 48 year old male with a relevant past history. With a relevant past history, and he was presented with non-specific abdominal pain. There is an unremarkable general and abdominal examination, no microscopic hematuria, and with also with normal lab findings. He ultrasound and MRI was were performed elsewhere and was referred to the urology center with MR and ultrasound examinations. On ultrasound, the kidneys show bilateral hypoechoic lesions, replacing almost all the right renal parenchyma and the upper bowl of the left kidney with enlarged right kidney. There is diffuse hypoechoic pattern with some cystic area with thin-walled septi. And this is the T2-weighted sequences on MRI. There is diffuse hyper-intensity sparing a lower polar segment of the right kidney with focal hyper-intense areas. And the left kidney, the same pattern was detected in the upper bowl of the left kidney. This is the contrast-enhanced sequence. We can see here, this is the lesion here, non-enhancing. And this is the normal remaining part of the parenchyma. And the same pattern is seen here in the upper bowl of the left kidney. So the enclosed report based on ultrasound and MRI was bilateral renal infarction, more on the right side. And due to the enlarged right kidney and the hypoechoic edematous pattern was suggested to be a venous infarction. فاللي موافق على على الدياجنوزيس ده من حضراتكم يرفع ايده كده. اللي موافق؟ مفيش حد موافق. طيب اوكي, انا مش موافق برضه معاكم. So we do a non-contrast and contrast-enhanced CT. This is a CT at the site of the lesion of the right kidney and upper bowl of left kidney. On a non-contrast CT, there is bilateral areas of low attenuation between 15 and 22 Hausfeld unit, and the same distribution at the same distribution as MRI. No calcification, no renal or ureteric stones. So this is a contrast enhanced CT. The CT angiography show patent renal arteries and veins bilaterally. And this is the area seen on MRI on the right side and here on the left kidney. This lesion on the left kidney and this is the upper bowl of the kidney. And this is the coronal reformatted image. This is the large area of the right kidney and smaller on the left side. And this is the coronal, sagittal, and axial images of the renal lesions. So This is a delayed excretory phase of the CT study, and we can summarize the CT findings that patent renal arteries and veins then enhancing low attenuation and cystic areas involving most of the right kidney and left upper bowel, and intact pelvicalceal system and renal hilum with preserved excretory function of the kidneys. So any thought about the final conclusion? حد يحب يقول final conclusion؟
أقول؟
لا, one diagnosis, Mr. Frey.
Lymphangioma.
مش أنت هيثم, أنت عارفها.
أنا أول مرة أشوفها على فكرة. شفت باترن قبل كده مختلف, بس دي أول مرة أشوفها.
This is lymphangiomas. So lymphangiomas are rare benign malformation of the lymphatics. Microscopically, lymphangiomas have been classified as capillary or simple, cavernous or cystic, depending on the size of the lymphatic, of the ectasia of the lymphatic space. So the most common location neck and axilla, 95%, with the remaining 5% of all sites scattered, including the kidneys. So there is three types of renal lymphangiomas. Renal parenchymal, like this case, intrarenal lymphangioma, and perinephric tissue or perinephric tissue involvement, what is called perirenal lymphatic cyst, and renal sinus cyst, or peripelvic lymphatic cysts. So the most rare type is the renal parenchyma, like this case, and the most common of these three types is the renal sinus peripelvic lymphatic cyst, followed by perirenal lymphangiomas. This is our case, parenchymal lymphangiomatosis. And the differential diagnosis of renal parenchymal is urinoma, autosomal dominant polycystic kidney disease, multinuclear cystic nephroma. But the bilateral intrarenal distribution of finely septated fluid collection with no enhancement are suggestive of lymphangiomatosis. This is a peripelvic or renal sinus cyst. Usually it's a small cyst on the small kidney on the left side, but was also with lymphatic collection in the renal sinus here on the excretory phase. Peripelvic lymphatic cyst. And the peripelvic lymphatic or collection is different from the parapelvic cyst, because here it is multiple cysts in the renal sinus, and the parapelvic cyst usually is solitary cyst, and the origin in the parapelvic is the renal parenchyma, that is to say it is a cyst arising from a renal parenchyma adjacent to the renal pelvis, so it grows in the parapelvic location. But here in the renal sinus, so it is called the peripelvic or sometimes the peripelvicalceal cyst because it reaches to the minor calyces. This is a case of peripelvic cyst. We can see here this is a multiple cyst on the more in on the right side, but also multiple cysts in the renal sinus. And the coronal nephrographic phase image, it resembles hydronephrosis, but as a delayed excretory phase is the diagnostic. We can see here normal calyceal system. Here the peripelvic cyst is seen surrounding the pelvic calyceal system. So it is a peripelvic lymphatic cyst. On this case, we can see it is mimics hydronephrosis in the nephrographic phase. But on the delayed phase, we can see that the pelvicalceal system is not obstructed and is only surrounded and displaced by the peripelvic cyst. So the other type is the perirenal lymphangiomatosis. We can see the lymphatic collection surrounding the kidney here, and also here on nephrographic phase CT. bilateral peripelvic, and here another case from the literature, bilateral peripelvic cyst on axial and sagittal on the right of the right kidney. And sometimes there is a combination between usually between the perirenal and the peripelvic lymphangiomatosis. So the intraparenchymal usually is not associated with other types, but here perirenal and peripelvic lymphangiomatosis. Thank you so much for your attention.